Enzo Ferrari was a racing driver and entrepreneur. In 1929, he founded the Scuderia Ferrari team, initially the racing team for Alfa Romeo, building and racing cars under the Alfa name. He, of course, went on to build and run his own race and then road cars. And here's our earliest Ferrari in the parade, a 1952 Ferrari 212, which was retired to Coupe. As we got to the 1960s, Ferrari realised it could make money in America and globally, thus paying for its racing. Here's a 60s classic that Ferrari developed specifically to target the US market as a true GT car. This is the 1966 Ferrari 275 GTS making its way onto our display. Our next model marks a move into a new market area called Ferrari. Although the car was very much a Ferrari, it was never sold as such because the company branded their smaller cars Dino as a mark of its own right, named after the delicious son Dino Ferrari. Today, however, Ferrari do refer to this range as Ferrari Dino. The example you see on our display ramp has the original Dino badge. It's 1973 Dino 246 GTS. And now for a record-breaking Ferrari alongside our display ramp. This was the successor to the Ferrari 288 GTO. It's the F40, launched in 1987. Its name was given to it to celebrate Ferrari's 40th anniversary. It had its original design under Group B regulations, although those Group B regs were abolished before it was fully developed. But it's still a mighty quick car. The Ferrari F40, the first road-legal car to break 200 miles an hour. Next, alongside our display ramp, is a 2003 Ferrari Enzo. The Enzo followed Ferrari's tradition of making halo models, and each was designed to be the ultimate supercar of their day. Made in limited numbers, it was announced during the period when Michael Schumacher, Jean Todt, Ross Brawn, and Rory Burnley Dream Team were dominating Formula One, and the production was limited to 400 examples. Ferrari Enzo would have cost you $652,000 a year. Just making its way onto our ramp now is a car that is truly two words that most people would never think to put in the same sentence on Ferrari and estate. This is 1965 Ferrari 330 GT VDR estate. It is the only one of its kind in the world ever produced. It is currently on sale by German Car exhibiting here at the show, and its previous owners include Jamiroquai lead singer JK. Back up to the top of the Grand Avenue is our 1952 Ferrari 212-225. This particular example won the 1953 Coppa Inter Europa at Monterrey, the international race meeting. It was driven by Franco Cornaccia, who was a Ferrari agent. Look at the Ferrari F40 revving it up as he makes his way back up towards the display around the area. Just coming back down the Grand Avenue, that 1966 Ferrari 275, followed on with the Ferrari 250. Total 917 were produced, but only 200 examples of the 275 GTS variant were ever built between 1964 and 1966. It has a 3.2-litre 12 engine and kicks out 260 brake horsepower. Blue Ferrari Dino makes its way back down the Grand Avenue as well. The example shown here has been extensively restored. The unusual but correct blue Sarah Metalaxian colour, which perfectly highlights the beauty of what is a Pininfarina body design. With the sales of the Dino 246 GT stable, Ferrari looks to increase the popularity still further by introducing an open version of the 246 GTS. Made its debut on the 1972 Geneva Motor Show. Reactions to it were immediately very positive indeed. Most of the records at the time were held by the AC company. The first of our single seaters onto the ramp is a 1923 Aston Martin razor blade.
Early in the season.
Ferraris and 98 degrees. The car can reach 90 miles an hour in second gear. It's affectionately known as the missile. It's got an aluminium body and an aluminium engine, so it's actually very lightweight. It's around about 700 kilograms. Currently, it's on sale by Vintage and Prestige for £850,000. Supercars on the Grand Avenue at 4:45. Thanks very much. We'll see you later on.